We have an update for the Batman Return to Arkham compilation. And as we have reported on it before, this is going to be a remastered collection of Batman Arkham Asylum and Arkham City. It's going to be coming out on PlayStation 4 and Xbox One. It was supposed to launch on July 26th, but at the end of June, Warner Brothers held back and pretty much said they wanted the quality to get better with this game. Now, I have up on the screen that picture of Hugo Strange and the remastered version compared to the original version. And I'm glad that they're going back and they're doing this. And apparently we won't be seeing the actual update is we won't be seeing these remastered versions of the games until November at the earliest. So July, let's see, August, September, October, November. That's a 4 month delay. I'm pretty sure it's a result of the reaction to. I'm like 99% sure it's a reaction to the or it's a reaction to the reaction rather of those screenshots that were released. And apparently they were actually done by a fan that just went and grabbed screenshots from the current versions that we have and compared them. And it's actually interesting because the company that is doing the remaster, they're called Virtuous. They've worked on the PS4 version of Heavy Rain, so the remaster of that game, and they also helped a little bit with Uncharted 4, and they even created assets for The Force Awakens, Star Wars Episode 7. So they're not a small-time company. They're definitely not a one of these weird porting companies that sometimes companies will get to make a quick compilation of something and it turned out pretty subpar. I'm thinking of like the Devil May Cry HD collection, which they did nothing for the menus or the videos or the not videos but pre-rendered cutscenes. Like they still all played in standard definition on a high def set, which looks terrible, and all the menus were still under that they hadn't upscaled those at all. The only thing that was up, they didn't touch the textures, nothing. It just basically was, oh, it's a PlayStation 2 game which is natively running at high definition. I don't even know if it was 720p or 1080p, but anyway, sometimes these remasters or compilations really turn out bad. So this kind of restores a little bit of hope that I have in this game. Like I thought, okay, this could be like the last we hear about this and we don't get it. But it seems like no, they're still actually going to work on it. It's just weird that we don't have anything solid, that we went from the end of June or in June saying, hey, we have this coming for you in a month and a half to 2 months, and then before that month is even over, you basically withdraw it and you don't give us a new date. That doesn't really happen.
Yeah, that game that was going to come out like 5 days from now, it might come out in November.
Like, wait, what?
If we finish on time.
And the problem with that is, they honestly, I don't know what they did to mess us up, but they should have gotten this out in July Because summer is notorious for having really, it's really dry as far as game releases go. It's very sporadic. You may get a game that launches one game every couple of weeks that comes out on consoles and that sort of thing. So for them to have to wait till November, the holiday season, when they're going to be competing with lots of big titles that are coming out. Also, you have the BioShock collection coming out too. I want to say there's one other remaster collection that we've talked about before that's also coming out.
I think it was Dishonored.
Oh, Skyrim is also coming out.
Yeah.
That's a huge one that I know that a lot of people are looking forward to. So you really should have gotten this done right. And you know, at the same time, you know, I'm also glad that they're doing this. I'm glad because nobody wants a buggy game. And especially, it really doesn't ever make sense when you release a buggy game on a version of a game which ran fine on previous hardware. Capcom, I'm looking at you as far as Resident Evil 5 goes. Like, that never makes any sense. So, yeah. November, maybe.
Yeah. I'm glad they at least... I'm glad that they're working on it and they're not just, like, giving up entirely on it based off, like, what people have said. Because I feel like a lot of people would get that because it's like a... three games in like a bundle that costs like $60 with all the DLC for it. So, I mean, it's fairly worth it for how much content you're getting, even though it's a last-gen game. But when things are glitching and just like the graphics look the exact same as they did in the last generation of consoles and a next-gen console that's about to get a halfway point upgrade. I just don't know how you don't see that. Like, how do you look at that, say, that's okay, and then go like, hey, look at this awesome work that we've done so far. This is coming out in 3 months, and then release it on the internet, and then have, like, some 18-year-old kid who played the game like 4 years ago be like, this looks terrible. What's wrong with you? You're not done.
Yeah.
No, go back to do your job. Like, someone who doesn't do that for a living, if they can tell, or no, I can't even say that. Like, anyone could look at those and clearly see, like, oh, this one looks better than that one, or that looks worse than this one. And you'd be like, guess what? This is coming at next-gen consoles. It's like, but
yeah.
Why, though?
Especially after you've played Arkham Knight. Arkham Knight is a gorgeous game. Not the PC version, but Xbox One and PS4, it's easily one of the best-looking games that I have ever seen. I mean, it's up there with like Uncharted 4. It has just incredible visual fidelity going for it, and it really shows what Unreal Engine 4 can do. This does not.
No.
This looks like, you know, someone's playing around with Unreal Engine 3 and not getting that right.
Yeah, this is like a bunch of third-year college students who are just like, hey, do you want to go ahead and make like a version of this game? And then they make that, and then they try and like sell it. So, and even then, like taking four months at the earliest to finish this, like that's kind of long, especially with how far you've gotten in the game. Like the game was supposed to be released last month, and it's going to take you at least 4 months, maybe, to do everything that you need to fix. Like that's a lot.
That's just maybe. Maybe November we're going to see it.
Yeah, that's a lot of work that needs to be done. So Like, if this had been released, if they just ignored what people had said, it would have just destroyed the game.
Yeah, it would have been, it probably would be looked on as a lot of people looked at Arkham Origins, which was handled by a different company other than Rocksteady, and that was buggy beyond belief too. So, but at the same time, they're going to miss their window. Like, people aren't going to be, you know, wanting a remastered version of these two games, despite how good they are, when they're going to have competing with Skyrim and BioShock and other new games that are coming out.
Yeah.